I think that it was very important for ECIO to feature an emergency in interventional oncology session, as you know that prevalence of cancer is increasing in the general population and improvements in treatments allow to prolong survival. So the incidence of oncological patients presenting in the emergency department with acute condition will continue to rise. Some complications are insidious, developing for weeks or months, but some other are very fast with the devastating scenario. So you need to obtain a prompt diagnosis and treatment, and interventional radiologists play a pivotal role in this field of interest.
It's important to cover the emergencies that can occur in the interventional oncology setting, because they're not always included in the routine training of all interventional oncologists. So we all learn about the oncology end of our patients in terms of the tumors that they have, how best to treat their tumors. We're constantly working on the evidence base for our treatments, and emergencies are just totally outside that realm. So in terms of the hospital setting, many trained interventional oncologists are already in their posts and are unlikely perhaps to go back and relearn or retrain how to perform transarterial embolizations. But it's important that they have a close working relationship with their colleagues who do perform those procedures. And just as it's important in terms of building teams to deal with our oncology patients, it's important that there are recognized pathways for communication between the oncologist and the surgeon, the oncologist and the IO, the surgeon and the IO, so that the pathways of communication are clear and open at all times.
The most important take-home message from the session on emergency was that an oncological patient needs the same management of non-oncological patient. However, you have to consider the complexity of the patient, so you need a patient-focused treatment plan. You have to consider also the tumor staging, the response to treatment, the outcome of the patient, and also patient and family wishes. So you need to work in a team in order to understand which is the best treatment plan for the patient.
During the session, it really struck me what an enormous impact interventional radiology and interventional oncology can have, not only on the patients themselves in terms of saving their lives at the time, but also in terms of saving their families from an extremely distressing death. So by preventing these kind of severe emergent deaths, we do not only the patient but the family a great service.